In this video, I'll show you how to use our brand safety tools that give you full visibility into what ads are being shown in your app and take action on problematic ads. So before we get started, I'll cover a few use cases for our brand safety tools. Two of the most powerful ones are Ad Review and Creative Debugger. They help you monitor and escalate bad ads to your network partners, which we'll get into shortly. So instead of managing creative across multiple platforms, everything is centralized for you within Max for easy detection based on the rules that you define. Another great use case for publishers running user acquisition campaigns is competitive monitoring. Use Ad Review to set customized rules to automatically detect what your competitors are running in your apps and gather intel on the latest creative designs that drive the most installs to help with your own UA campaigns. A few important notes are Ad Review should be used for creative monitoring. This tool does not have a blocking feature, so make sure you let your account team know if you need an ad, an advertiser, app category, or creative blocked from your app. And then to be able to use Ad Review within Max, it must be enabled within the App 11 SDK. And you can check out our integration documentation to learn how to do this. So right now we're on the creatives view of Ad Review. To get to it, you just pop out the left nav, go down to Ad Review, and then hit creative, which that's where we are right now. From here, you can see a gallery of all the ads that have served in your app. And you can see that they're intelligently grouped by the network that served it and the title of the ad. You can take actions on this page like reporting an ad that you don't like to your network partners. So clicking this, we would report it. This is an AppLovin ad, so you can see that here's a field that you would like to type in your account team's email addresses so they can receive it, and you're already in the CC, including the your account's email address. And then you can send a message like, please block this ad. And all the details that are related to this ad will be sent up to the account team once you hit send report. You can also do filtering. So for example, we can type in AdMob. And that network will come up and we hit apply. And then all of AdMob's creatives will be filtered. Right now we're looking at the last 7 days. There's other filters too, give you a lot of options to be able to like drill down into the creative that you want to see. So platform, specific advertiser, through an application you're interested to see if it ran on your app. And there are advanced filters. Like content rating, or if it created video, or if you actually have the creative ID, you can drop it in here. And then within this view, we can see full screen ads and banner ads. If you click on a creative, it'll give you more details about the specific creative. So in this example, we're seeing the creative is Dessert DIY. AppLovin served it, what platform it served on. Here's the creative ID, when it was last seen, and even the DSP within the AppLovin exchange who actually served it. One cool thing, which we talked about at the top of the video, is being able to use this for competitive monitoring, or just getting a better understanding of what messages are resonating with users to drive installs. So we have this user engagement field that shows us the viewing time. How long are people spending with this interstitial ad? Take the average time that users are spending with an ad, and if you're seeing like any outliers, very high viewing times, like definitely take that as a sign that this particular creative is doing something right, and it might be one to keep an eye on. So viewing time is a really great metric to keep in mind. From this page, you can also report an ad, add competitor or risky rules, which we'll cover shortly. You can see the creative. You can even see the creative in action by hitting play.
What are you doing?
And that was the ad. Down here, we just have some quick metrics, like in the last 7 days. Right, last 7 days, how this creative the impressions that it was serving. So started out really high serving impressions and started to drop off in the last couple of days. And now we can see that this particular creative served really heavily in Indonesia and a few other Southeast Asian countries. The ad review gallery can be regrouped by risky content, competitors, and advertiser campaigns. These options are already created for you in this section and mimic the same functionality as the creatives view. It's just how you set your rules, and the rules that you set will dictate how this creative is populated into these galleries.